Rossetti had told him at some time that he should really try to become the bard of Manxland. Those were Rossetti's words. And although when Hall Caine first started his literary career, it wasn't the Isle of Man he thought of foremost. His first books were set in Cumberland or the district around it. But he had this childhood connection with the island, and he felt he wanted to write about the island. And he went to Hugh Stowell Brown, who was a family friend. He was a famous Baptist minister in Liverpool, a really great man, and did a lot of social beneficial work for the working class. Anyway, Hugh Stowell Brown, he was T. Brown's brother, had very bitter memories of his poverty on the island. The family were poor, that's to say it was a large family living on a very small stipend, and they used to get charity boxes with used clothes and things like that. And although T. Brown never felt that that was an insult, Hugh Stowell Brown did feel it very humiliating. And he disliked the Isle of Man for that and other reasons. So when Hall Caine came and said he had been thinking about writing a novel about the island, Hugh Stowell Brown said, "Oh, don't attempt it. Nobody cares about the Isle of Man. It will be a disaster." And then I suppose Hall Caine must have sort of objected a little bit, and Hugh Stowell Brown said, "Well, if you want to talk to my brother." But they were already in correspondence and developing a friendship, because T. Brown had written to Hall Caine, and from that their friendship developed. So Hall Caine then developed the theme for the Deemster, and T. Brown was very skeptical about it, and said he couldn't, in the present form that Hall Caine suggested, it would not be a good book. He had to reconsider. So from the very beginning, T. Brown advised on his books and sort of discussed the plot lines and so on with him. And then when they were published, he was very supportive, and he took, particularly when the Manxman came out and had such adverse reactions on the island,